Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Survival Island. Little recap for you. We've got our chicken farm. We've got our beacon. And that means it's time to go on a little journey. So, let's go. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. What we have been working on or working towards this whole time, we're actually about to start. So we've got to craft some things up before we head out. We're going to make an emergency bed just in case we get into a spot of trouble. We're also going to make an ender chest in case we come across some fun stuff that we need to bring back to the home base here. And then, most importantly, the boat. Yes, I could have done this the whole time. I could have gotten that boat because we started with some trees. We've got trees over there, but all in all, let's take a look here. Just think about what we have gotten accomplished. We got the agricultural area. We never did get cows to spawn over here. We'll probably see some on this trip. We've got a fisher that's going to break in 1.11. That's why I've not switched to the snapshots yet. I don't trust them. We've got a mob farm, and we've got our beacon. And we've got potions, and we got our chicken farm, so I do believe it is time to go. So, what I want to do is, we've kind of already seen over that way some. We know that there's an island over there, but what I want to do is not hit the escape button. I want to see what the boundaries are for this ocean. So, I want to maybe go this way. We know that there's a little bit of land that way. I want to go this way and see what we might be getting into. Right, wait a minute. Hold that. Let's go to where we actually have a boat dock, right? Let's go out this way and through here and then over this way. And we'll just double back around our survival island just for grins and giggles. But we're going to launch from the boat dock. And I think it's probably time for a little sneaky screenshot. Like so. Not so sneaky, huh? You can see it in the text. But there we go. We're going to go into F5 mode. I really like boating in F5 mode now. So let's see what we can see. I do want to collect some things as we're out and about. If we come across like sugarcane or cactus or, I don't know, different tree types, because oak can get boring. So if we see anything else, then I think we'll go, we'll grab that. Okay, we've got some land over this way. Let's see what might be here. Looks like a little island. And while we are boating around, let me just have a chat with you about some things that are upcoming. Now, we hit 500 subscribers, and I said I was going to do a 500 sub special with a Q&A, but that never happened. What in the world is that, you know? Yeah, I didn't do the 500 sub Q&A special because I didn't get enough questions. So what I wanted to do is maybe try something a little different. And we're going to go for a 10 stack special instead. So we're going to go at 640 subscribers. We're going to try and get some more questions. And so I am going to ask you, is there anything that you would like to ask Soap? I will entertain all questions. I may not answer all of them, though. So I will reserve the right to refuse to answer some, just depending upon how personal they might seem. But yeah, so if you do have some questions you would like to ask, feel free to use the comment section down below or catch me on Twitter at MCSoapTheGreat. Alternatively, you can ask on my ask.fm page. A link to that is in the description box below, so feel free to go there as well. Make sure to tag it with Soap640 or something like that, unless you want me to answer it immediately, so I know that that's what you want to do. All right, so our first order of the day is to examine the beautiful floating flower. So wonderful. So we'll go there. I don't really care to get more flowers, but we've got another tree type here. So yes, I know, birch. Who likes birch? I like birch. So I don't like the log so much, but the leaves are really nice. And the wood itself is a nice shade. So let's see if we can get a sapling, hopefully. And this is just going to be the name of the game. We're going to go do some exploration. Hopefully I get a sapling. This is not faring so well. Maybe I should have put fortune on my axe. That does actually work. No sapling. Well, that is pretty terrible. So how about over here? Let's grab this guy. Ooh, and some sugarcane. Excellent. 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 We got pigs over here. I don't think they're within the spawning range. There we go. We got one. We need to get a couple because we've now taken down two trees. And you know what we do on the Soap the Great channel? We regrow. That is the name of the game. So, okay, we got one more there. Let's do that. We leave it as we found it or better. For the most part, I am digging a perimeter on a server, on the Hypermind server, so that's definitely not leaving it as I found it or better. Hopefully I can get, yes, got another sapling. Good, good, good. So we will replant over at that original one. You know what? Even here, we're going to leave that as we found it. So that is all that I need from there. Let's continue on our journey. And let's do the regrowth here. I can't remember quite where it was. We'll just do that. All right. So let's get back into the boat. Hopefully I remember where it was. We've got a nice little plains area here. No horses or anything. It's not like we need horses over at our island home. But it'd be nice to try and find some horses eventually. Let's head back to the boat and we will get going to some other part around the ocean. All right. Well, I've sailed around a little bit more and here we go in a, what is that, forest hills over there to find some sheep. So that's something a little different than what we've been used to. So I've been wondering if there is actually any life on this planet, given that we have not seen much on our island other than chickens. But it's just looking like forest again. I'm going to try and double back around and go maybe to the north and east. No, north and west of the survival island. So let's head over that way and see if we find something interesting. Well, I have been sailing for quite some time and we end up with a birch forest. Wonderful. Wonderful. Let's see what else might be around here. It's quite a distance from home. What's over here? Ooh, roofed forest. This is a good thing, so we can get some of those lovely dark oak saplings and hopefully not encounter too many baddies while we're at it. So let's get out of F5 mode. I really do like F5 mode in the boats. And now that boats are a lot better than in previous versions, it's actually fun going in a boat, whereas before it was an exercise in frustration. But here we go. Let's just take all this wood down. Anything else? And we're not going to regrow this because we're probably not going to get all four or enough saplings out of it to regrow both this tree and take some of the trees back. So we need to get four, and we got two. So let's see. Oh, we got one right there. Can we reach? No, we can't reach. We'll put that down. Okay, we got third one, and then one more just hanging out there. Okay, if we do manage to get an additional four, we'll replant, but I don't have high hopes for that. So did we get that one? Yeah, there we go. So we got five. Yeah, I don't know if we'll get any more. But yeah, there we go. So roof forest, let's see what might be around here. I don't want to go too far inland. The whole point right now is just to kind of peruse the boundaries of our ocean that we have been surrounded by. And this is a nice little area. We got a bay structure over here. Oh, and the roof forest goes on and on. So we're in, ooh, that's nice. A little peninsula or something? Let's see. This would be a nice place to build. Well, I do, or I will run a map once we do this. I have occasionally run them, but, and again, there's no secret that I do run the map, and I chose this seed ahead of time, so I kind of had an idea of what was going to be available, but yeah, I will, I think, you know, at the end of this episode, I am actually going to reveal the seed to you, so you guys will be able to play along if you so desire. But that is it for taking a look at the roofed forest. So I think we should cut and we'll see what else we might be able to find. Well, looky here. We got a desert. This is a good thing. I need that cactus. And so we're over here. You see these particle effects? I think that's pretty cool. And that's new in this version of Minecraft in 1.10. They've got particle effects for floating gravel, floating sand. So just something to keep in mind if you ever see that. Ooh, sand-colored bunnies. Cool. Is there anything around here worth venturing too far inland on? It doesn't look like it. You see, let's see, what's over that way? That's a hill, but I want to keep my boat close by. So we will skirt the coast here once again, kind of like the explorers of old. Don't go too far inland until you have a chance to really, really map out your surroundings and stick to the coast. So that's what we're going to do. And if I find something pretty cool, I will bring you back around for it. All right, you see what's coming into view here? We found a savanna. So we will hole up right here, and we will walk around and see about getting some of these acacia trees, because I would really like to use those in a build. Oh, looky over there. We've got a village, and it's got a blacksmith, which is pretty cool. So let's grab this. And again, we're going to replant, because that's what we do. So we'll wait for these. These usually drop a decent amount of saplings. So there's the first one. We'll always plant the first one. There we go. Okay. We'll get a couple of these. They drop a lot, actually. So you should never have to worry about getting enough acacia saplings to replenish. It's just jungle and dark oak tend to be the worst. So over here, we've got beetroot and wheat, which we've already got in our thing. What in the world? There's no chest. That is no bueno. Why in the world would that have generated without a chest? No idea. And there's no villagers either. That's not... That's no good. No good at all. No good at all. So, is there anything else? Why would there be no villagers? Is this close enough to... This should not be close enough to me to have spawned zombies. That's really strange. Very odd indeed. But anyway, I like the overall generation. We've got path blocks. This is part of the new 1.10? Yeah, 1.10 added the path blocks. But it looks like it should have been using the new... I wonder if we're close enough that... Let's take a look at our F3. Let's see. Block. We might be close enough, based on my mining, to have actually gotten over here. I wonder if that's the case. I'll have to take a look. Maybe go and check the biomes when I'm when I'm down in the mines again. We might be close enough, and that's why perhaps that did not get truncated. Who knows? I can't remember. Anyway. Oh, well. So, no blacksmith shop, and there are no villagers. That's problematic indeed. But hey, we've got a village right there. I'm used to the sleep mechanism on Hypermine. You see that? Walking onto the bed and waiting for it to do the command block thing. But no go. Anyway, we are going to sleep once again. And we're going to go around, and I think this is the... Let's see. Spawn is roughly... That way. So we're to the northeast. We've been to the southeast, southwest, and northeast. So it's time to go to the... northwest. Southeast, southwest, northwest. It's time to go to the northeast, and we'll see what we can find. All right, back in a bit. You know, what's odd to me is that in traveling over this whole ocean, I have yet to run into an ocean monument. And that's part of the updates from 1.9. They spawned, this is fun. So ocean monuments spawn less frequently in 1.9 than in 1.8. Is that 1.8 added them? Yeah. So looky here. This is gorgeous. Look at that. We've got a jungle. We're going to spend a little bit of time here for sure. We've got to get some jungle saplings, and there should be melons available on and around the area here. So let's get out of F5 mode. We'll get out of the boat. And why do we have sand? Let's come up here. What biome are we in? So this should be beach, okay. Not quite out of or into the one that we're after here. Come on. Okay. Still beach. Jungle. This looks like Jungle Hills, actually. Yeah, it's just jungle. But that's cool. It's nice. Nice little area here. So we've got to collect. I'm going to maybe tear down that one right there. Right here. This one? No, maybe this one right here. Since it's right on the edge, we'll just come down right through it like this. And we'll see, do we get any? There's no cocoa beans. So that's no good. I'd like some cocoa beans. Oh, they put... I don't like the jungle bushes there. It's oak leaves around a jungle log. I've got plenty of oak saplings. We can turn off F3, too. Jungle sapling? Yes. No. Maybe so. We might have to tear down a couple, and we may not be able to replenish these. If so, that would be kind of horrible. See if we can get a jungle sapling. And we'll need to collect some cocoa and watermelon as well. But let me tear this down, see if I can get a sapling, and we'll continue looking for the rest of the items. All right, looks like we got two saplings, so we can put one of those down. Maybe that one shouldn't go as close to that other tree, just to make sure it gets plenty of foliage. All right, so we got that. Next up, cocoa beans. I saw some around here somewhere. Yeah, there we go. There's some. And means we should be able to find some ocelots around here too, but given that I've got so many chickens at spawn, we may not be able to get too many passive mob spawns around in the world. So that might be a downside to having the chicken farm there. And in 1.11, something else is going to be changing, and that is they're going to add something called max entity cramming or something like that. It's a new game rule, and what it's going to do is it's going to suffocate mobs if you've got too many in a single block area. So that includes iron farms and and chicken farms and stuff like that. So something coming up in 1.11, if you've got an area where you've crammed a bunch of entities into a spot, you'll need to watch out, because I'm not sure what the exact rules are, but they are going to, or some of the, at least some of the mobs are going to die of suffocation. So something to keep in mind. What I'm looking for now is some watermelon. Do we have any around here? There should be some. At least they used to spawn in jungles. I wonder if that, hopefully that didn't change. Do you see any watermelon? There's some over there. Okay. Ooh, a little cave. Is there any on this side of the island? Over here, anything? There's a sheep. Okay. Watermelon. Okay, I guess I have to go over to that side. And I've got Feather Falling 4, so I should be fine. But I just don't want to get too far from my boat. That's all. Anyway, let's get up here to our goal. We'll get some... Oh, the jungle just keeps going on and on. This is good. It's probably one of my favorite biomes. Wow. Oh, there we go. Okay. It's a nice little grotto there. Let's get this. And... got watermelon. All right. Let's go back to the boat and we'll explore the area around here a little bit more, but just by boat. All right. Okay. It looks like a nice little bay in this area. We'll just keep going around. This is pretty cool. I wonder if this is attached to anything else. Let's see. Jungles are, in terms of biomes for Minecraft, Minecraft does biomes that it's got a temperature marker and a moisture marker. And so jungles are very humid and they're also warm. And so they tend to get close to other warm biomes, like you can see a desert coming into view here. And this, I wonder if this is the same desert that we were at earlier. We're not too far removed. Anything of interest over here? So it looks like this is more, this is continental area almost. So we'll turn back around, go around the other coast and see what we can find. But yeah, we've got warm and humid, and this is warm and dry. And so biomes generally, and I say generally, the rules are not always followed the best in the terrain generator, but the rules generally say... warm biomes go next to warm biomes, and humid biomes go next to humid biomes, and so it kind of decides between the two. So sometimes you'll see some really weird ones, like mesas showing up next to ice plane spikes, which is just makes you scratch your head. But anyway, let's go back around. You've already seen this terrain here, so let's go back around and see what we can find. So far, it is looking like jungle, and more jungle. Let's go through here and see what we can find. We got a little jungle islandlet there. That's a little thing there. Let's come over this way. I wonder what's over here. Is this back towards home? I can't remember. Ooh, more jungle. Okay, well, maybe we'll leave that for some other time. Let's come over here and see if there's anything new. Because jungles also have jungle temples. We'll see if we can find something like that. And if we do, we'll stop in and get it. But we've seen stuff like this before. Okay. Watermelon. Okay. Jungle over that way. There's a lot of jungle. I did not do this with large biomes, by the way, but it's just looking like this jungle goes on and on. Ooh, cow. Excellent. So we can come to the jungle here and get some cows if we want to move them back to spawn, but I don't know that I do. One of my long-term projects here is to do a passive mob farm. You might be wondering, what are you talking about? One of the things I want to do. Well, I do want to continue in this world. I want to have this as my single player world, but the whole concept of Survival Island apparently is now done because we've completed our objective, right? So yeah, we'll have to figure out how to work this in from here on out. But yeah, so this jungle is kind of interesting. I like that right there. It's looking like this one is almost surrounded. Let's see. Let's keep going. See if we can find a stop to the coastline here. And maybe I'll do a little speedy up bit, starting right around now. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that island looks familiar, and we've just gone all the way around the coast here, which means we've returned right to where we were, which means that this area right here is an island. So you know what that means, right? That means that this entire series has been one giant jungle island adventure. There's home base, and here's an island, and we got a horse, and two cows, and two pigs, all this time, right here. Sheep, cows, pigs. So close, yet so far.